Salutations to the Supreme God, all Yogacharyas, Yoga Gurus, for divine protection with full faith, with lots of gratitude and lots of love. Today, we are celebrating the 6th International Yoga Day with great pleasure and joy. As we all know, International Yoga Day is now one of the most auspicious days celebrated on 21st of June from 2015. And this day will always find a special place inside every proud Indian's heart. Stay home, stay safe. Keeping this in our mind, we begin this lockdown yoga day with the sun salutation and various other asanas videographed by our students within the confines of their own homes.
Surya Namaskara, also known as the ultimate asana, strengthens your back and your muscles and brings down sugar levels. It improves metabolism and blood circulation, thereby giving a glowing skin.
Yoga is an invaluable gift of India's ancient tradition. It embodies unity of mind and body, thought and action, restraint and fulfillment, harmony between man, a holistic approach to health and well-being. These are the words by none other than our Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi in the United Nations General Assembly on the year 2014. Every child needs complete health and support, which aids their courage to pursue their dream with ease and one-pointedness, especially amidst the global pandemic of COVID-19. We all come to the definite conclusion that the current young generation should be equipped with greater immunity, strength, and mental faculty as well. And not only that, even in the academics, with the improved concentration, each and every child who practices yoga scores more in the exam with less stress, aiding his or her proper mental health and tranquility with even better divine guidance. Keeping the physical benefit as one of the best benefits of yoga is how it helps a person to manage one of the greatest enemy of modern mankind, stress. We all know that being stressed has devastating effect on the body and mind, especially for students. Yoga can be a savior on the occasion as it teaches automatically, or we may even call it conditioning the mind. Yoga helps in developing skills of control and reaches for a positive outlook. Now we all know that yoga improves one's physical, mental, spiritual as well as social well-being and helps uplifting the culture and serenity. So, on this occasion, let us unitedly pledge to ourselves to set aside a specific time for a short yoga practice session each day to keep growing to a better individual.
Second phase of yoga is pranayama. In pranayama, we have to take deep breath and hold for few seconds. Exhale slowly, rhythmically. Again, you have to hold for few seconds. Yoga science says, when we control our breath, we control our mind. Third phase of yoga is meditation. Sit in comfortable posture and chant mantra Om, Amen and Amen. Now we shall wind up the session with this chanting. Please close your eyes. Chant the mantra Om, Amen and Amen. Om. Slowly return to your body now. Let us do thanksgiving invocation to the Supreme God, all our spiritual teachers, spiritual gurus, yoga acharyas and yoga gurus. Thank you for your priceless blessings. We thank you in full faith. Thank you.